गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द लैटिट्यूड एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड्स, द ज्योग्राफिकल ग्रिड लैटिट्यूड्स एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड फॉर क्लास 9th, चैप्टर 2. इन दिस स्टूडेंट वी आर गोइंग टू सी लैटिट्यूड्स एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड्स इन डिटेल. सो लेट्स बिगिन दिस चैप्टर विथ कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम. We'll differentiate coordinate system with the geographical grid. Student, first of all, you can clearly see the location of a place on the earth surface can be located through the help of coordinate system. Now you can see that what is coordinate system? It is a simple geometric relationship between the perpendicular axis. You can see there are two axes, x-axis and y-axis. Student, it is called as, zero is called as point of origin, and the units are, you know, depicted along the x-axis and y-axis. Okay, now you can say that the origin point from which it start is on the lower left hand corner. Okay, it is a lower left hand corner, and as we go along the x-axis and y-axis, now the coordinate is represented through, which is a main point represented through the star, is represented on 7 x-axis and 4 y-axis. Okay, so this is the main reference points. Okay, so through the coordinates, the point of reference can be easily located on our earth surface. Now the question comes, can we use the same methods to represent or locate any place on our earth surface? No, our answer would be no, because our earth, okay, for 2D, it's a 2D diagram, two dimensional means which has length and width, is called as two dimensional. On our earth surface we have a three dimensional yet. Okay, means three dimensional means length, width and depth also. Okay, now you can see the same methods can't be used here. We can't use it here because it's a three-dimensional. Earth is a three-dimensional. It's a sphere. On the sphere, for locating any place on our Earth, we need two things at the same time. Number one, the two sets of lines and the reference. The reference is the poles. They are the poles. The reference are the poles, the north pole and the south pole. So for locating any place on our earth surface, we need two things at the same time. Number one, the two reference points which is situated on our earth surface in the forms of poles, north pole and south pole, and two sets of lines, latitudes and longitudes. What is latitude, longitude? We'll see it later. First of all, we'll see latitude in detail. First of all, you can see clearly here, students, these latitudes are nothing but it's a, angular distance of, any place from the equator. It is a angular distance north or south of equator. Okay, by taking equator as a reference point, we take equator as a reference point and we mark the angular distance north or south of the equator. For example, you can see here clearly, students, here we are taking equator as a reference point and we start marking degree. For example, it's a 1 degree. So all the places on the earth surface which are situated at the angular distance of 1 degree will be marked by the same line. So okay, that will be the 1 degree line.
which will cover our earth surface. Okay, so let's see here. Now we are moving towards the first one diagram. Now with the interval of 1 degree, there are total 90 latitudes in the northern hemisphere, because our earth is a sphere and half of the sphere is called as hemisphere. So in the northern hemisphere, if you will put a protector here, you can mark 1 degree here. So with the interval of 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree, up to the 90 degree at the poles. So total 90 degree in the northern hemisphere and 90 degree we can mark in the southern hemisphere. It comes 180 degree. Okay, now in between the each degree we have another 60, you know, lines, which is called as minutes. So let's see here. 1 degree is equals to 60 minutes, and each minute can be further divided into 60 seconds. It means that in between 1 degree to 2 degree of latitude, we have another 60 lines of 1 minute, and each minute further can be also divided into 60 seconds. So in between each degree, 1 degree to 2 degree, if you are taking 1 degree to 2 degree, in between them there are 60 more, you know, lines of minutes with the interval of 1 minute, 1 minute, 2 minute, and further the each minute can also be divided into 60 seconds. With we represent it with double inverted comma, it's a second. Okay, so one, it's clear to you, I think so, student. 1 degree equals to 60 minute, and each minute further can be divided into 60 second. So we have total 180 latitudes. Now you know, this time we are discussing latitude mainly. In the next video lecture we'll discuss longitude. First of all see, we'll some basics. Okay, so what are the latitudes? As I explained, student, it's a line, but in reality it is not a line. For the 2D image it's okay, but because our earth is a three-dimensional figure, so actually these latitudes are the circles, complete circle, which are the angular distance north or south of the equator. We can see, I have marked already the, you know, degrees up to the 90 degree. So first of all, the equator 0 degree is also called as the great circle, because it is the largest circle than any other circle drawn on our earth surface. So it is also called as equator because it's divide 0 degree, its value is 0 degree, it's divide our earth surface into two equal halves, that's why it's called as equator. And because it's the biggest circle than other, you know, circles drawn on our earth surface, that's why it is called as the great circle. Okay, then after that you can see there are the circles as we move in the towards the higher latitude, the size of the circle will be decreased, and when we reached near the poles, it will be in the form of point. Okay, so poles are the points. Okay, now we can use the same method in the southern hemisphere also. Okay, now a second thing, all these lines, or you can say that in reality these are the circles, are parallel to the equator, that's why sometimes it's also called as the parallels of latitude. Okay, now as you can see, students, what's called the length of the arc of 1 degree, the length of the arc of 1 degree of latitude is approximately 100 kilometers. The length of the arc of 1 degree. Okay, for example, if from the center if you mark, okay, 1 degree, so the length of the arc of 1 degree, it's called as arc, is equals to 100 kilometers. But when we move towards the poles, okay, so whatever the length of arc of 1 degree near pole will be little bit different from the arc of the length of the pole. Why? Because as you know that our earth is flattened at the top. That's why, you know, there's a, you know, a little bit difference in the length of the arc of the equator. And now the question comes, how can we find out the length of the arc of any place? It is through the circumference of the circle. Circumference of the circle divided by 360 degree, because the total measurement of the earth is 360 degree, and here circumference of the circle is the, you know, degree measured by us from, by, you know, taking reference from the center of the earth. Okay, so we can get how much it is. So there are 111 kilometer. What is the length of the arc of 1 degree of latitude is 111 kilometer. It means 1 degree equals to 111 kilometer distance on the earth. Students, now we are going to see there are two ways by which we can easily find out latitudes on our earth surface. For example, if you have missed your path and you are on the strange place, then how can we measure the, you know, latitude easily? So first of all, the vertical angle of the pole star. By measuring the vertical angle of the pole star, we can get latitude. And another way is latitude can also calculated by with the reference to the zenith distance or the angle. From the zenith distance or the angle that the sun max with the zenith. The another way is that the with your zenith, the angle made by the sun is also used for calculation in order to finding latitude. We can use the second method also. Okay, so up to here, students, we have seen the coordinates and the latitude, its extension. Okay, now in the next video lecture we are going to see the longitude, okay, in detail. Till then, keep revising these topics.